Welcome. We'll begin with the Kurukshetra February edition. This edition exclusively focuses on how can we improve the agricultural prospects in India. So we have various schemes through which we have been going through the various Yojana in the Kurukshetra. The most important ones again, the Fasal Bima Yojana, the Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana, the Krishi Sichai Yojana. Then you have the Farmers First scheme, that's new, that's important. You have the Ready scheme, again new, which would be important. The Arya scheme, again new this time, which would be important. So these are some of the important aspects. Then our main focus would be the agri-business component. So let's go through these one by one. Before that, let's have an outline about the editorial that was discussed. So you have the PM-AASHA scheme that talks about the holistic arrangements for remuneration that could be done for a kind of price stable environment that could be created. You have MROK app, that's basically for the medical health. Then under the agriculture, we believe 70% of our population is engaged in agricultural activities. We have the various contribution that has been coming to the national income from agriculture and allied activities. Numerous funds have been flowing in the projects like micro irrigation, where you have nearly 5,000 crores. You have dairy processing, where you have nearly 10,000 crores of investment that has been done. Similarly, you have the agricultural market infrastructural development fund. You have the fisheries development fund that has been up. We are trying to increase the minimum support price for the farmers, mainly for the kharif and the rabi crops that's there. Under the Fasal Bima Yojana, we are talking about the premium that's around 2% for kharif and 1.5% for rabi crops. The payment for 25% of the loss claims would also be made immediately, and that would be through an online portal. That's again important. We have also released the e-naam facility, that's the electronic national agricultural market, through which we can bring in more transparency into the system, improve the agricultural production, agricultural marketing. Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana is targeted for eco-friendly approach, for organic farming approach. Similarly, we have numerous schemes related to the soil well-being. So you have the soil health card, that's there, use of fertilizers, micronutrients. Then mechanization in agriculture is again promoted. This has been launched to increase the crop yield, mainly in the areas of Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh and the NCR areas. Rashtriya Gokul Mission is very, very important. That's basically upbringing the indigenous breeds. So you have the National Kamdhenu Breeding Centers that are there. India has the first position in terms of milk production. 19% of the total milk production comes from India worldwide. We are working around deep sea fishing. So that's again new objective that we are trying to attain. You have the Nakul Swastha Patra, that is basically working around the health of the cattle and the milch animals. We have the Farmers First Mera Gaon Mera Gaurav and the Arya scheme that has started. Arya is, as we said, important and new. So you have attracting and retaining the youth in agriculture, and this scheme is basically making the farming practices more attractive for the young people who are educated and who can join basically the agricultural sector. You also have the entrepreneurship promotional efforts that are running through. Similarly, when we talk about the procurement policy, we have a new procurement policy that has been up, and this procurement policy has three alternatives. The first option talks about the procurement would be by the government with the help of the partners, which are mainly the states. The second is the seller would be paid a minimum support price for the crop that he would be selling, and that would be done or taken care by the government. The third option is the trade will procure these products, but the trader who is basically intermediate would have to pay the minimum support price for the same. Similarly, for the marketing, we are providing a kind of assured marketing schemes. We are talking about value addition of the crops, providing high value crops with a favorable impact to enhance the income of the farmers. We are also talking about reducing the imports of the pulses, the oil seeds, and basically saving the foreign exchange and increasing the foreign exchange earning. Now, institutionalized credit is very, very important. So we have the Mudra scheme that's there. We are talking about more investment coming up in the agricultural sector. This is basically to generate more income avenues, reduce the poverty levels, increase the food security levels in the country. We have numerous cooperative banks, the RRBs, the cooperatives that are being associated with it, various rural banks. A lot of credit inflow has been working around. So all this is basically working mainly with the financial sector. So you have the regional rural banks, which are providing the highest support. Then you have the cooperative banks that are also there. We are talking about the commercial banks, which have registered a significant growth over the past years. But the sole aim is to cover the small and the marginal farmers, which are so far not covered under the institutional credit system. So Kisan credit card scheme is one of the good ways to promote it. We are financing the various self-help groups. We have farmers produce organization that is being running. Negotiable warehouse receipt is another important aspect that is being covered. Now this what would do is basically enable the farmers to monetize early, and even if there is a distress situation, the farmer would be easily able to come out of that distress situation. Under the research and initiatives, we have the research and extension. We have numerous initiatives that have taken place. So we have high variety of mung beans that's rich in protein, that's known as Virat, that has been released. You have rice variety CR-10, 310, that's basically again rich in protein. We have Medka grapes, which are basically having cancer fighting properties. You have Solapur pomegranates that are rich in iron and zinc. So zinc is basically considered an immunity booster. So those are the kind of efforts that have been going in. For the livelihood generation, we are talking about doubling the farmers' income 2022. So the idea is basically improving the security of the livestock that's there. So you have numerous projects that are coming up and numerous species. So you have Jharsim species, which is commonly seen in Jharkhand and Bihar areas for the poultry birds. Similarly, you have Madhya Pradesh, where you have Narda Nidhi. In Assam, you have Kamrup. In Himachal Pradesh, you have Himsar Smriti. So those are the kind of species that are there, and those are really, really important. We have the Abhishan Abhiyan, that's basically for the sheep rearing. So these schemes are important. There are severe infestations that could be seen. Those could be in the form of swine flu, Jones disease. So these can form your objective questions for your prelims examination, so are very, very important. Integrated farming approach is again important. We are trying to improve the employment skills, horticulture, dairy, fishery, optimizing the byproducts. You have a three-tier system where the farmers can grow three vegetables at a time. So three different vegetables at a time is the idea, and this has been successfully running in most of the North Bengal, Northeast parts of the country. Then we have been moving from the laboratories to the agricultural fields. So you have Krishi Vigyan Kendra, which are basically talking about technology support given to the farmers. You have new such kendra that have been launched across the country. You have numerous climate resilient villages that are coming up. Numerous contingency crop plans have been demarcated. A very good institute that has been started is the Nanaji Deshmukh National Phenomics Facility, and that's basically for the agricultural research to overcome the situation in an adverse climatic condition. So what could be an alternative in an adverse climatic condition is a main aspect. Mera Gaon, Mera Gaurav is where scientists would work around five different villages, and they would bring in farmers or expose farmers to the new developments to bring in more entrepreneurship skills. Farmers First scheme, as we said, is again important, where farmers and scientists would have an interface, and scientists would be working directly with more than 48,000 farm families and farmers directly. So that's Farmers First is a very good initiative. Micro irrigation is a new approach where you have sprinkler irrigation, drip irrigation, agri guns, rain guns, pipe systems that have been released. And this has been in line with the National Water Policy 2012 in order to increase the water efficiency. The benefits basically, as we said, is checking out the energy efficiency, the use of fertilizers, the efficiency of that, increasing the productivity, bringing in more cost-savvy irrigation facilities, introducing new crops, increasing the farmers' income. Okay, then you have the micro-irrigation, which is basically increasing the farmers' income, bringing in more area under cultivation. Low cost of cultivation, mainly for the irrigation, has been taken into account. So technology is one of the prerequisites. Har khet ko pani and more crop per drop. So with every drop of water, you are trying to have more yield. So that's again one of the major objectives that has been under the Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sichai Yojana. We are talking about the Gujarat Green Revolution Company Limited, established in 2005, and the idea was to provide a good infrastructure for a holistic development to check out the conditions in adverse climatic conditions. So implementation of these technology become important. We have numerous expensive micro irrigation facilities, irrigation systems that are coming up. The power outages and unscheduled maintenance should be checked in. The size of the land holdings are decreasing. So that's again an important check that we need to take around. So those are some of the important aspects that we work around. When it comes to storage and marketing, that's again a very important aspect. So cold chain storage, value addition is again important. When you have the perishable goods, you are trying to have an improved version of your cold chain storage. The losses that are occurring pre-harvest, post-harvest storage and transportation are again taken into consideration. So spontaneous movement of the things are very, very important. Now what we are talking about is a kind of unique agricultural market in India. We have post-harvest operators, assembly, grading systems that are coming up, good storage system, good marketing systems that would be coming up. Now, when we talk about the marketing, we have government initiatives that are coming up. Those can be in the form of market infrastructure, a regulatory measures that could be taken, and a good price control policy that should be taken into account. We have numerous Agricultural Market Produce Committee Act that has come up. So APMC Act, as we call it. Now, this act has several implications. It first check over the malpractices that are running over. Then it talks about a fair price, transparent system that would be there. And direct marketing would be made simpler. There would be new agricultural markets that could be established. So ENAM or the Electronic National Agricultural Market is one such example. Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana, as we said, is done for organic farming. We are trying to boost more of agriculture through the agri-business. Now this includes checking around the inputs that are there, working around the production in the agricultural field, the processing and the trade that takes place. So government has numerous incubation centers that have come up. We are talking about research and support in these centers. There are numerous technologies that have been started. Now eco-friendly preparations have come up. You have sustainable business models that are running. Now, one of such is a circuit collaboration, calibration, that's basically for the cotton textile and the cotton trading that has come up. Now, READY program is important. So, Student Rural Entrepreneurship Awareness Development Yojana. Now, this talks about hands-on training for practical purposes, giving students more practical outlook, experiential learning, creating more awareness, giving smaller projects in the rural areas where they can have kind of industrial attachments with the units. We also have the Livestock Marketing Act 2017 that has been running. So that again is very, very important. Numerous price support system programs have come up. We are talking about a kind of holistic development. Food Corporation of India has been working in line with this. So the Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sichai Yojana has seven different aspects. One is the mega food park, integrated cold chain. We have agro processing clusters coming up, interlinking the backward and the forward clusters, creating an expansion of the food preservation centers, maintaining the quality and human resources. We have Operation Greens that is running. That's basically the top scheme. That's the tomato, onion and potato scheme that has been running in. Now, when it comes to irrigation, we are talking to encourage farmers to have better varieties, follow a good cropping pattern, work around a kind of assured output for the crop cultivation, even when there is moisture stress that is seen. So this Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sichai Yojana basically has four components. First is Har Khet Ko Pani, more crop per drop. You have watershed development, an accelerated irrigation benefit program and command area development program. You have 99 small and medium, which we call as MudCore projects, MudCore projects that have been running through. So these projects become really important. Then under the accelerated irrigation benefit program, we are talking about improving the agricultural potential. You have numerous inputs coming in from NABARD and other institutions. You have underground pipelines that are running in, laser land leveling systems coming up, cultivation on a raised or elevated bed, that is again important. You have intensive water management strategies coming up. Rice intensification has been seen. We have micro irrigation systems that are coming up. So we are talking to increase the yield up to 100%. We are trying to save water up to 70%. grow crops more consistently, use fertilizers more efficiently, the cost of fertilizers should be reduced, chemical applications should be promoted, and a kind of best insurance should be provided in case of droughts or any other adverse situations. We have the solar inputs that are being used, which are in the form of solar photovoltaic pumps. Soil health cards have been used, and some other important developments are basically, one of the most important among them is a sanitation park that has been established in Sivan in Bihar, and that's basically highlighting the sculpture of thinker, which is very similar to one created by the French artist. We also have the agricultural funds that have been flowing in mainly as agricultural credits, and you have the ICAR, which has been established since 1929 and has been working for agricultural research, education and extension programs. We'll be talking about Yojana and many more editions in the upcoming lectures, so stay tuned. Have a wonderful day ahead.